For a guy, he has skunks in his barn. He wants to take care of. We set a couple wild traps the other day. Come up, and today we have a black possum, kind of a gray black possum, with one eye missing. If you notice, if you can see that, it's one blunt. Looks like it was put out one time or another by something, but it's definitely not a fresh wound, but. Anyways, get him taken care of and see if we can get the guy's skunk caught for him. What do you know, guys? I'm Anthony Asher, Asher Brothers Outdoors. And we got back from a trip today. And we just left this morning, came back this afternoon. And I just went out, you know, check traps, you know, I was in a good mood. We got some big deals coming up from the Asher Brothers. But anyways, I just went out to check traps. And I've already got two skunks that I'll show you in a second. But I come into the new property we're trapping. I don't know if I told y'all about that or not, but we come up, drive through the gate, and look up there, and what do you know? We got ourselves a coyote, number 17 for the season! And from here, I can tell he's mangy, which makes me even happier. I'd rather catch the mangy once, get them out of the equation, and you don't have to skin them. I'm not a fan of skinning. I'm not a good skinner, and I'm not a fan of skinning. So, he's dancing around, he's testing that old Sleepy Creek 1 3/4. Let's get up there and check him out. Let's see. We'll drive. There he is, tangled up by back, no, it's front foot, in that Sleep Creek 1 3/4 offset from Southern Snares and Supply. Brian McKee sent it to us, and he isn't happy to be there, and as you can see, there's no hair on his tail, his hind end's mangy, his belly's mangy, he's mangy. I mean, not the worst one I've ever seen by a long shot, but he's still mangy. Not too huge. I hope you can hear me. It's starting to blow right now. But, Jesse! Leave him alone! But anyways, we caught him here. We just got this gate opening right here, as you can see. And we got this. It goes into the creek. It's kind of just a, kind of like a smaller creek that runs into the bigger creek, as you can see. They're both dry. Jesse! We've got kind of a road that comes through here with these power lines. Coyotes like to travel the power lines. They're often the territory boundaries. And when I said it, as you can see, there's a lot of trails coming out here, but there was a distinct one coming right through here that been kind of marred up because they put a round bale right here, right between two sets. Guess he doesn't like what he's doing a scratch kick. That's what they do when they get a territorial response to something. They don't like it. They'll start doing that number. So if you ever see that around your sets, you know you got a good territorial response. Anyways, you put it right on the trail during that real cold spell. That's the coldest weather we've had in 50 years. Since, no, not quite 50 years. I believe it was the winter of 83 we had real cold weather. Of course, I wasn't around, but anyways, good pot catching that Sleepy Creek 1 3/4. It was kind of a scat set slash flat set. We just had a small rock. In fact, it's right there. And we just put a piece of coyote scat in front of it, freshened it up with Southern Snares coyote urine. That's potent stuff, guys. And then on the rock, we put some of Winter Wildlife Control's coyote gland lure. It's just straight coyote gland. It's 100% natural. It's great for use during breeding season. We're getting towards the end of February now, so coyote breeding season's about out. Bobcat breeding season is starting to come in. But we nailed a good left paw catch, actually. As you can see, let's get you a better look at that trap. There we go. Good paw catch. As you can see, no damage. He's got some mane, Johnny. Wish he'd stand up so you could see his belly, but so that's where he's. Sorry, guys. Camera cut out on me. Batteries went dead. But anyways, this is part of the reason we trap right here is to keep the diseases from spreading. We get this guy out of the equation. He won't be infecting other animals around him with mange. That's a terrible way to die. In fact, I'll see if I can get my friend to send the picture to me, and I'll post it on this video of a mangy coyote he caught. As you can see, it's really bad. So we want to get them out of the equation. This is a much more humane way for them to die than for freezing to death or just dying because of the disease, or freezing to death because they have no hair. But anyways, I'll stop my rambling. We'll get this guy taken out of the equation, and we'll do the remake. I don't know if you can hear from the wind, but we have good news. The vaccine is working! I guarantee you. Get that vaccine. You, or whatever you give it to, will never, ever, ever get the coronavirus, or any other virus for that matter. Here's the second patient that we gave it to today. And he's going to be doing a little poorly right if we gave it to him. So we went ahead and gave him his second booster round. And, well, he's just sleeping right now. Feeling no pain at all. And then, got one in the back of us taking a ride with us that we just gave the vaccine to. You see, he's still sound asleep. We just gave him the first dose, and he kind of lurched forward, and he fell asleep like 5 seconds after I gave it to him. So this vaccine works, guys. All you need is your vaccine administering syringe on the end of a pole. You can get this. It's called a Barker's skunk sleeper. A Barker's excuse me. A Barker's vaccine giver to her. Get these in Southern Snares and Supply and give your animals the vaccine. I guarantee you it'll work.